She pauses for a few seconds, lost in thought. Yep, if I were younger... She! What is up, my Yeehee crew? I am Kirk Yeehee, and this is West of Loathing. I'm gonna say it right off, this is a request from T-Money, so if it's bad, blame him. I know I always say that, and it sounds mean, but he knows I'm joking. So I'm not sure what any of this is. Okay, I don't really care about the name. You can be Josephine Ford. I don't know what any of this is about, so I'm gonna choose the ugly teddy bear. So that's just changing our names, huh? Great. I guess now we're Leonard Ware. Get the mouse out of the way there. Apologies for that. I don't know where to go to... here we are. So we're going to play. This is one I've always wanted to play, but I forgot the name of it. So I had the strangest dream. I was choosing a character class. Cowpuncher, Beanslinger, or Snake Oiler. Okay, after looking these over, I think I'm going to go with Cowpuncher. Because it had the longest description. I'm not using keyboard and mouse, so I don't know why it showed me WASD. This weird poster appeared here one night. You read the spine of your books, The Adventures of Forbidden Cave. I love that one. Read another title. Ruth Hardy and the Mystery of the Skeleton Mine. Great. The Journey of the Eagle Warehouse. Okay, we've had enough of that. I wasn't done in there, though. Good, I can use the D-pad to move at least. Goodbye, desk. Comb hair. Why hair? I have no hair. Comb your hair one last time. You gain 1 XP. Our character has no hair, though. Hey, Russell, how you doing? Ha! I'm going to miss you, buddy. Ha! 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 You grab a cricket from your cricket bag and feed it to Russell. He coos appreciatively and nuzzles your hand. Goodbye, Russell. Be good. Maybe it's time for you to leave, too. We'll set poor Russell free. Maybe it's time for you to leave, too. You open your bedroom window, not pictured. Of course it isn't. And unlatch the door to Russell's cage. He winks at you. I'm sure he does. Calls one last time, then flies away to the west. It's time to hit the trail. What the hell? I don't know what that said, but we got experience for it, so I'm not going to complain. Nothing on the hat rack today. This hearth really puts the hearth in home. I don't get it. You're gonna miss Mom's cooking. It's Mom's pie safe. It keeps all of her pies safe. It looks like a cabinet. You'll miss the meals with the family. There's no one else here. Ooh, was that a door I saw down there? Okay, that's probably where we go to leave. Your little brother's room. You pick up one of your brother's weird books and flip through it. Salutio. Not even gonna try it. Nope, we're leaving. I want one of his toys. Can we take one of his toys? Hey, he loves his stuff. You got an item, puzzle cube. Awesome, we can. So tidy. It's covering all this weird diagrams and charts, or all with all his weird diagrams and charts even. Is that Ma? No time to screw around in the woods. Time to head west. So we literally have to go west. Your mom smiles warmly as you approach. I'm leaving now, Ma. We're going to miss you, kiddo. Oh, and before you leave, I got you a present. A present? Yep. Oh, that was her. Yep, looks like it's a book you wanted for Crimbo. I know it's early. What the hell's Crimbo? I know it's early, but that one about picking locks, that one about desert survival, that one about bartering. Picking locks seems like it could be important. You got an item, locks and how to pick them. Please be careful and write us a letter when you can. I will, Ma. Goodbye. How do I use that? Do I just... Okay. Awesome. Great. It's already solved. You mess it up again, it's messed up forever. That's not true at all. Okay. What's Y do? Just moves that menu, huh? Left bumper goes into that. Right bumper goes into... Oh, there's a lot of stuff here. Colorblind mode confuses me with a black and white game. I think that's the joke and all, but it's just stupid. Hello, are you Pa? Your father morosely jabs at the haystack. I thought you were going to say jabs you with the pitchfork. That hat doesn't fit you, Dad. Time to leave, Dad. We're going to diss his hat. I'll grow into it. I'm sure you will. It's time for me to leave. His lip quivers a bit. Listen, I want you to have this. It's your grandmother's brass knuckle. What? Thank you, Paw.
Good luck out there. Be sure to say goodbye to your mother.
I did. Goodbye, Dad. Goodbye, Paw is more like it. Okay, so they automatically equip the brass knuckles. 4 to 5 damage. Can I almost guarantee you there's going to be a needle in the haystack joke here. Sure enough. That one was too obvious. That one was way too obvious. Neon did all of his work. Your brother Rufus stand there and looking nervous. He's pretty good at looking nervous. Give him his puzzle back. You hand him the puzzle and he starts fidgeting with it. Hey, Rufus, time to head out west.
I still don't understand why you're leaving.
He's got a point, you know. Why are you going west anyway? To help people seek my fortune. To get off this stupid farm.
Rufus, you know how much I hate it here. I can't stay. I've got to go where the action is.
I've got to give up the accent. I'm no good at it.
But it's dangerous. 60% of the people that go west get killed within a year. And the statistics is from before the cows came home.
What is with all this cow talk? I'll be okay. You worry about taking care of Mom and Dad. I'll worry about me.
Okay, if you say so. I still think you'll be dead by Crimbo.
Great. I'll miss you, Rufus.
Okay.
Not I'll miss you too, just okay. Fantastic. Head west. You want to believe it. Hitching a ride across the Great Plains. Are we the one on the back? We gotta be the one on the back. You just skipped credit sequence where your character rode a turnip cart across the Great Plains into a sleepy town of Boring Springs. Great. Highlights of the trip included a bunch of the creators. I'm sure it was spectacular.
Well, hello there, friend.
I'm moseying here.
Great. I can pick up a turnip. Can I pick up the coconut? I cannot. Ah, pointy. Wait, is this hurting me? Where's my health? HP 20. Good, it's not. BS Horse 3. A sign on the door reads, gone drinking. Okay, so let's see what's in here. This game requires a lot of reading, doesn't it? As you walk into the saloon, the crazy-eyed guy sitting to the left of the door shrieks and waves at you to get your attention.
Hey, where's your hat, dagnabbit?
Well,
you can't drink here without a hat. Tain't proper.
He points to the take a hat, leave a hat box. Great. How convenient. You look through the hat box and find a sturdy-looking Stetson. That looks like something you wear. Okay, 4-gallon hat. You grab a hat and turn it on. Thanks,
Pete.
Thanks, Pete.
Say, fella.
Yeah?
You heading west? If you know some company, I'd be happy to come along. Just let me know.
Well,
no pressure.
All right, I'll keep it in mind. You crazy old coot. Look at his eyes. I was trying to walk past him. What do you say, Pete?
Who, me? Well, heck, I say all kinds of things. For instance, gold dang machines can't trust him no more than a double-crossing claim jumper.
Uh-huh. Pete takes a swig of his whiskey. See you later, Pete. It's a spittoon. People spit into it, you know. Without looking into it, it's absolutely disgusting. Nope, you decide to back away from this horrible stink bucket? Nope. I don't blame him. I actually knew someone back when I was a kid that used to have a spit bucket, and it was, so disgusting. Hello there, sleeping stranger. What are you guys doing? These two are playing poker, at least trying to. They keep looking back and forth from their hands to the how to play poker card that came with their deck, biting their lips, concentrating really hard. I can't play. It requires 20 meat. Okay. Hey, barkeep. You walked up to the bar and patiently wait for the bartender to notice you. While you're waiting, you see a sign taped to the back of the wall reading, reward for lost mugs, 25 meat each. So meat is your money, huh? Oh boy, I hope this keeps going. And by this, I mean my wireless microphone, because it's less than 3 months old and it's already giving out on me. Keep waiting. The bartender finally notices you.
Howdy, cowboy.
Howdy, barkeep. Name's Leonard.
What brings you to our little backwater?
My voice, he just like hit super puberty there. Ask about work. Oh, the usual. I came out to make my fortune. Have not have much luck so far, though. Any work around these parts?
Unfortunately, Boring Springs already has more people in it than jobs. It's more of an errand town, if you catch my meaning. If you're looking for a real job, I'd recommend talking to the railroad people up by Dirtwater. Ask about the railroad. Oh my God, there's so much stuff. The railroad? The Manifest Destiny Railroad Company from back east. They're trying to run a line to Frisco and having a heck of a time doing so. Are they hiring? Oh, I reckon they're always hiring for one thing or another. Big company, that. Ask about Dirtwater. And what about Dirtwater? Dirtwater's interesting. It's far enough west that it's still more or less exempt from the rule of law, but not so far west that it's been burned to the ground by the damn cows. Lots of opportunity there. She pauses for a few seconds, lost in thought. Yep. If I were younger... She got a deep voice. If I were a younger woman, I'd probably head off that way myself.
I guess we'll ask about errands. You mentioned errands?
Yeah, this forsaken burg has always fallen apart in the way, or one way or another. The holster's always needing help since he hurt his leg.
A hostler, not holster.
And no, that ain't account of sheriff. And that no account sheriff even could certainly stand to have somebody doing his job for him.
Anything else?
Well, I've got a goblin loose in the basement. Some cow poking from the gulch, didn't wipe his boots off, got some spores everywhere.
I can probably handle a goblin.
Much obliged, I'll unlock the basement door for you. Oh, and you'll need this.
Weak fungicide, really? And that's a woman? My God, there's a lot of talking. So before we get too far, I guess I should say, if you're enjoying this video and want to see more of this stuff, feel free to hit that subscribe button down below, or in the corner, or somewhere. It's all over the place at this point. In any case, howdy.
Howdy, good to see you again, Leonard.
You tip your hat to the bartender. My God, there's just so much with this bartender. Who's that fella at the bar next to me?
Well, maybe you should ask him that yourself, seeing as he's right here. He won't bite you.
Oh, that gulp. That was a deep-sounding gulp. Who's the lady drinking whiskey from the beer mug? Why is she willing to tell us about Susie but no one else?
That's Susie. She's a rancher from nearby. Real tough broad. I ain't recommend you pester her.
Why's that?
Lost her whole family to a cow attack recently. Got some pent-up frustrations about it.
Ouch. Are cows like the main evil to this or something? I'm so confused. Hello, stranger.
Howdy, I'm Leonard.
Howdy, Leonard, I'm Horace.
Nice to meet you. What do you do?
I'm the town holster. Hostler.
He even says holster. I don't know what that is.
I'm the town horse selling. Oh.
I never knew they had a specific name.
I'm the horse, or the town's horse selling guy.
Gotcha. How's that working out for you?
Oh, these horses are just flying out the door.
So business is booming? Nice.
No, I mean the horses keep running away. I haven't sold one in ages.
Oh. Is that why you're drinking here instead?
Yep. Me being here and drinking instead of watching the horses is probably how they keep escaping. It's one of those vicious circle things.
Snake eating his tail type deal there.
Well, I'm in need of a horse. Do you have any left?
One. Kind of a boring one. But it's got four legs and a back to set on. Come see me at the stable and I'll be happy to show you.
Great. Well, they just disappeared.
The woman glares at you.
Howdy, Susie.
Oh, no. You shouldn't have entered, or you should have said, howdy, I'm Leonard, and let her introduce herself.
Howdy, cowboy. Who's going to be searching this spittoon for his teeth if he doesn't leave me in peace?
Okay, then. Bye. Hey, I should probably leave him alone. Okay, so this must be the goblin. Oh, the shadowing's pretty cool. Old pile of newspapers. Can I do anything with that? Apparently not. Effective against goblins, 4-gallon hat. Oh, I can actually take that off, but it lowers one of my stats. I don't know what muss is. You dust off the turnip and eat it. Now you understand why people don't tend to eat raw turnips. You gain the effect turnip fueled. I'm not sure what that means, but okay, thank you. Okay, whiskey. Creative nurse brand whiskey. Good for what ails ya. I'll take a bottle of whiskey, I guess. Hello, friend. The goblin shouts, Briark, attack the goblin. Sure. He's going to beat me, isn't he? Got the jump on him. Okay, so this is effective against him. And it won't end my turn. Okay. Let's spritz him. What? That felt exceptionally strong. Having dispatched a goblin, you pat yourself on the back for a job well done. Well, that was easy. I feel like I did the wrong thing here, though. Can I get a different hat? Apparently not. Ew. Sheriff, great. I want to get my horse. Oh my god, he's so derpy looking. Horses, 1,000 meat. Afternoon, sir. What can I do you for? How's business? Oh, you know, every day I'm... Wait, haven't we had this conversation already? That's rough. Maybe I can help. Oh, God, yes. Thank you. Please, I'd fetch them for myself, except, you know, for this injury. I'll give you 300 meat each for finding them. Okay, so we're looking for horses. I skipped a couple of lines here because I thought it was all the same. Yeah, we're looking for the horses. You discover a new map location, Ornhole Mine, Boring Spring Boneyard, and Thousand Snakes Gulch. Why these places? I think they like the environments like that, thematically appropriate. Here, when you find one, feed us some of these oats. That should send them back here. Great. How does that work? They're special pigeon-infused oats. What? All the haystacks are gonna have needles, huh? Great. Hey, Derpy, can I have you? This is the most typical horse you've ever seen. Howdy, stranger. Welcome to Born Springs. I'm the sheriff in these parts. The what? The sheriff, okay? Blasted sign painters. Well, I'm a little confused. Say, wouldn't happen to be looking for work, would you? As a matter of fact, I am. Great, because I happen to have some. There's this gang of hoodlums around here what call themselves the Flicker Gang, or Fricker Gang, I almost thought it was the Effer Gang. Last time I arrested one of them, they busted him out and took my cell door with them. I ain't much good without that door. And I need some tough, smart, and or slick, oh my god, this is so hard to read, to go fetch him back for me. Why don't you do it? You're the sheriff, after all. Gotta stay here and practice my chair tipping. Great. I'll give it a shot. Funny you should have said that, because I'm sending the deputy along with you to keep you out of trouble. He takes the pistol out of his desk and hands it to you. You got the item deputy pistol. Deputy? You deputized a gun? You're new in town. Maybe you ain't noticed, but there ain't much to do here except drink. Here, let me write down the fricker... I almost said effer again. Fricker Gang's hideout for you. He makes a little note on your map. You discover a new map location, Fricker Gang's hideout. Where's this so-called map? Apparently it's select. Okay. And dang it, ouch. Step right up. Blade's a name, Trade's a game. You seriously doubt his name is Braid. Howdy, Braid or Brade? Braid? Broad? What are you trading? Well, sir, today I'm trading locks for soap and a stick of dynamite for a needle. Well, I happen to have a few needles. And the cunning skinner who brings me 3 rattlesnake hides? Well, to that adventure soul, I'll trade a fine silver pocket watch. I'll take some dynamite for the needles. Brave, which is so non-named, takes your needle and hands you a stick of dynamite. Be careful with this now. You got some dynamite. Awesome. I can't do any more trades, so I'll step right through that. Wait, what? Hello? You approach the weird cactus man hybrid. He smiles at you. Howdy, cactus man.
Howdy yourself. The name's Bill. Cactus Bill.
What happened to you, Bill?
Well, to be honest, partner, I drank too much cactus beer and it turned me into a cactus. Doc Alice warned me that this would happen, but I didn't listen.
And that's why they call you Cactus Bill?
No, that's just a coincidence.
Oh, does it hurt?
Does what hurt?
You know, being a cactus.
Oh, no, it's actually kind of nice. The natural fermentation process inside the cactus part of me is keeps me pretty drunk most of the time. I guess it is might boring.
Yeah, I bet it is.
It wouldn't be so bad if I had something to read. You don't happen to have a newspaper or anything, do you?
Well, I just so happen to do have one. There you go. It's not going to get you very far, but...
Much obliged, partner. Now, let's see here. What can I do in return to return the favor? Oh, I know. My shovel. I left it behind the outshed, or outhouse at the ore hole mine. It's yours if you go get it. I'm sure you'll find use for it.
We're almost there for a level up. Thank you, good sir. Thank you, Cactus Man. Cactus Bill. Behind the outhouse at Ornhole Mine. Got it. Thanks, Bill.
Don't mention it. Now if you could just kind of stick that newspaper to my face before you leave.
Oh, my God. Nope, you're not allowed to peek anymore, remember? No, I don't. Some loose dirt. Now, if I only had a shovel. Okay, so which spot should I start with? That's the question here. I think I'll hit Boring Spring. Where was the... I think it was the mine that the guy said he had the shovel. So let's... Yeah, right here. So let's grab that and go back and dig that hole up. All right, some loose dirt. You got to... Oh, great. That's a second mug I found. Still not sure what they're for, but okay. Now, let's continue on to the ore hole mine here. Awesome. We found 50 meat in a mine cart. Oh, another mug. Not sure what they're for, but okay. Nice and dark in here. The mechanism labeled cargo elevator control on a... Or a poster. I want to look this room over before I deal with the elevator. I think it's going to be... Unrefined meat nugget. What's that even mean? You can't get past this rubble. Now, if I only had a way to light this. At least there's no plunger hooked up to it, so we're going to have to find a plunger to hook up to that. Okay, so let's set the elevator. We'll start at level 1 and work our way down. Okay, we won't do anything because it's full of cargo. Guess we can't do anything here yet. We're going to have to go elsewhere and find something. I don't want to do the Fricker Gang hideout. That spot scares me. So we'll go to the Boneyard. Our founder, Zephyriah Boring. Great. He actually was a really interesting guy here. He was actually a really interesting guy. Okay. Wait, what just happened now? I want to get a feel for the battling, so let's see how the melee attack works for us here. Ow. I hope I get healed up. Wait, how come the pistol does less damage in my stupid fist? Why would I even ever want to use that pistol? And boom, that should be him done. I really hope they heal me up. You got an old cavalry saber and a gold tooth. Did they heal me up? I have 30 HP, so I'm going to hope they healed me up. What's this do for us? Nothing. Okay, so I can apparently just equip the saber over everything else and still... No, it takes my brass knuckles off. 4 to 5, and okay, it's a little stronger than the knucks, so I don't mind so much. Hello, friend. A skeleton, you're not getting past without a scuffle. A scuffle it is, then. Okay, so now we have a stronger weapon. Let's see how this thing goes. Ooh, almost dropped him in one hit. We can't take much damage from him. I want to use this to see how it... Okay. A little faster to attack. 3 XP. That guy just wouldn't stay put. Beauregard skeleton, captured 3rd cavern. Well, there wasn't anything funny about that. Wait, is this one of the horses? Your pulse quickens as you get near the spooky translucent horse. Okay. Hello there. I'm a friend, okay? That's a little strange. How did you do that without opening your mouth? Okay. You pat the horse's nose, which is very cold. If you're going to ride her, you want an extra saddle blanket to keep your butt from freezing. Pat her on the nose again. Yep. Still cold. Brr. Okay. Oh, no, it did change a little bit. It's changing a little bit more each time. You get the idea. Here you go, girl. Have some oats. You hold out a handful of oats for the horse, but it just sort of stares right through you. Please don't look at me like that. Try the oats again. You hold out the oats again, but the horse continues to ignore them. What's the matter? Are they not spooky enough? I'm not sure how to make oats spooky. I guess I could put some bone meal on them, but I don't have anything handy to grind up bones with. Grape dirt? Is that a yes? Weird. Okay. I'm so confused about what's going on right now. You sprinkle the oats with just a little bit of grape dirt and hold them out again. The horse gazes expressionlessly at them, then eats them. And with that, she glides away in the direction of the town. Bizarre. Bizarre is not the word I would have used, but okay. I'm not going to be able to get by here now, am I? God damn it, can I not pick away that there's actually anything? I guess we're going to go to Thousand Snakes Gulch. Hey, I can jump. Would you look at that? Ah, pointy, yeah. One of these rocks is really shiny. You grab it and you grab it and it's a shiny rock. God damn, I really hope this isn't hurting me again. Okay, hello, snake. The snake looks sleepy, but not that sleepy. I guess we'll fight it and hope for the best. Hee-yah! Oh. Okay, then. Progress towards skill 7 of 10. These guys are easy, man. Oh, no, this one's fast. Oh, we're poisoned, aren't we? Yep. Screw you, snake. Oh, one hit didn't take him down. Okay. We're still going to survive this easy enough. Go. The battling is pretty basic in this, isn't it? Or am I just making it basic? The snake looks really angry. You're going to need every trick in the book to beat this one. I'm good at tricks. Whoa, they're quick. We're poisoned again. Like, I don't know why I'd ever want to use this. It just makes no sense to me because it's considerably weaker than my regular attack. So I'm always going to stick with the melee attack. What's the point otherwise? Probably because of the class I chose, the cow puncher, whatever it was. I still don't get that either. I'm sure all will become clear if we pick up a second part. And that will depend on you guys. If there's enough interest in this, I'll continue to play it, but if there's no one that cares to see it, then yeah, it probably won't continue. So if you want, what's wrong with his eyes? If you want to see this one keep going, feel free to share this video out. The more people see it, the better, you know? This horse got one snake crazy, or has gone snake crazy, or maybe he was some other kind of crazy horse before. Approach him. I'd be afraid of getting kicked by this one. Hey there, boy. Hey, fella. I'm a friend, okay? I think it has rabies. Jesus. It's cool. All right, be cool. Don't freak out on me. You look him in the eyes. Pat his nose. I'll look him in the eyes. You calmly look the horse in the eyes. One of them's fixed in a glassy 1,000-yard stare, and the other one's revolving madly in its socket like it's thinking of trying to escape in every direction simultaneously. He looks to be calming down a little now that now that it's clear you aren't actually made of spiders, though. What? I guess I'll pat his nose. You carefully and gently pat the horse's nose. He twitches a bit. Okay, a lot. But it seems to recognize that you aren't going to eat his eyes or suck out his soul or whatever madness is bouncing around in that skull of his. That's a good boy. Feed him the oats. Are you hungry, boy? Got a little treat for you. I don't know if snurf is the sound I made, but you feed the crazy horse some of the homing oats and it gallops away with a whinny, or rather a hopefully he's headed home and not to the 12th dimension. Cool. Wait, seriously? Am I going to get the horse? You don't have to walk all the way over there. Hit M or click the map icon to quick. I don't want to. I want to walk, so screw you, game. I guess all that's left is to go to the Fricker Gang hideout. All right, this guy's sleeping. I can probably pass him. Thud Fricker, the Fricker Gang's intrepid lookout, appears to be taking a little nap. Just shoot him. That doesn't seem very sportsmanlike. You sure you want to do that? Yeah, I am. Really? You're just gonna gun down a halfless sleeping man in cold blood? Cold is the only blood I have. Shoot him. He's just a kid. Everybody dies. Pull the trigger. Dang, partner. You got a perk. Ruthless. Oh my God. Did I just murder a kid? He had a mustache! He wasn't a kid. I don't get that. Oh, there's another mug and some 20 or 25 meat. What are these mugs about? I feel like I missed something here. So I can go in here. I had no body. I can drown him. Well, I gotta do that. I shot a kid. So, oh my God, that's gonna come back to freaking bite me in the future. I shot a kid. Ha ha ha. At least I'll never be going for prime minister or anything like that, so I don't have to worry about it too much. Drown him. You push his head under the water and hold him there until he stops struggling. At least he died warm. Rub-a-dub-dub. I want some grub. I can walk right through it. How do these guys not see me? You cautiously approach the Frickers gang. They're pretty engrossed in their poker game, so it doesn't actually require that much caution. You hide behind a barrel and eavesdrop on their conversation for a while. The one with the eye patch is quiet, but you gather that his name is Snipe and that that the squirrely one is his brother Wimpy. What's your play here? Shoot one of them in the back, approach and talk, and leave without alerting them. I'm gonna play this role the whole way. You draw your pistol and execute one with the eye patch. His brother screams, jumps behind a barrel, and starts firing at you wildly. This shouldn't take long. Gotta jump on him. So, will I be able to just walk up and hit him? What's the point of the barrel? He never hit it. I'm just shooting him. Oh, if I shoot at him, I hit the barrel. Now I can just fight the barrel, okay. I don't know how to switch between characters, I just realized. Well, he can at least hit me now, so that's something. I just cut him down. I brought a knife or a sword to a gunfight and won, like straight up. Awesome, got another level. I also got a perk. What was that perk about? How do I check that? I don't know. There's a mug on the table, better grab that because, you know, they're so important. At least we can get this and take it back to the sheriff. And that means we finally have a quest done, or we will. Rub-a-dub-dub. I should probably just, no, can't go over in there. Okay, so, yeah. I should probably, I keep forgetting I can jump. I also forget I can do this. Great. I feel like we got a broken board. Okay. Now, let's talk to this guy. Looks like my pale horse market, or my pale horse made it back safe. Thanks for your help. Anytime. Thanks for finding my crazy horse. He's eating local weed again, wasn't he? I guess. Not that I noticed. Afternoon, sir. What can I do for you? Can you sell me a horse now? Sure thing. I only warn you, though, my horses get mighty attached to their riders. Once you bought one, you won't be able to change your mind later. Which one are you interested in? Spooky, crazy. Well, I gotta go with Crazy Eyes. Okay, but I warn you, that horse has seen some stuff. But I'll sell him for 1,000 meat. Rats, I don't have that much. I'll come back later once I get the dough. Because I really want Crazy Eyes there. Hey, Sheriff. I got your door. I see the Fricker gang hasn't put a stop to your breathing. Did you rescue my cell door? You hand the sheriff his door and he hangs it back on its hinges. Nice work, stranger. Here's the prison cell. Let me try that again. Jeez, this here prison cell just got about 4 times more secure. Are there any Fricker boys left for me to round up? Nope, won't be bothering you anymore. Well now, that's a right load off my mind. Looks like I owe you a reward. There's 500 more meat. That means I can get that horse. Got another little task for you, if you got the time. Should be a lot simpler than the last one. What you need? Well, the Frickers busted the lock when they took the door. Gonna need a new lock. I'll keep an eye out. Okay, so cell looks much better with the door back into place. More celly. I think I saw you with a lock, did I not? Yeah. I need soap. Where do I get soap? I gotta figure out where to get soap. I didn't want to go in there. Okay, so apparently she's willing to talk a little more now. Are you Susie? Are you Susie Cochran? How'd you know my last name? I saw the graves in the cemetery. Sorry for your loss. Susie scowls bitterly and mutters into her whiskey. I saw it happen. I saw the whole damn thing and couldn't do nothing about it.
It wasn't something like, wasn't, or was it the cows?
Cows, right? Don't know what those things are, but they ain't cows. Not no, or not anymore.
What happened?
It was a raid. See, Ma, Pa used to ranch the cattle, or ranch cattle, back before, well, they came home. Pa didn't make it, but Ma managed to rebuild. Ma and I managed to rebuild. We ranched pigs instead, and she left me in this place while, or when she passed.
Go on.
Well, I guess a passing herd sniffed out what used to be a cow ranch, and they attacked. A couple days ago, happened so fast, didn't even have time to get my rifle out to get out. Oh my God! I didn't even have the time to get my rifle out of the gun safe. Cow smashed the front door, and a fire started out back by the root cellar. What? How? Houses went up in blazes, just like that.
What'd you do?
There wasn't anything I could do. Couldn't get upstairs to the kids because of the fire. And I saw Tim trampled right in front of me. She drains her glass. I ain't want to talk about it anymore. That right there, I would expect to be like, I ain't want to talk about it no more.
Sorry.
She refills her mug from a bottle in the bar and doesn't reply.
Well, what will you do now?
Head west, I suppose. Nothing keeping me here. And no desire to stay. I can't leave without my rifle, though.
Why not?
It's Ma's rifle. It's all I got left of anybody.
Where is it?
Left it at the ranch like a damn fool. Listen, can I ask a favor? Need someone to go get it for me.
Sure, I'll go get it.
Susie shows you on the map where the ranch is. You discover a new map location, the Cochran Ranch.
Take your leave.
Okay, so I have nothing to do down there. I can go to the ranch, but I think this is where I've got to end it. I hope I can figure out how to save this game. I don't know how to save this game. Oh boy. In any case, this is where we're going to end it. So if you happen to enjoy this video, as always, leave it a big old thumbs up. I really appreciate that. If you did like what you see, feel free to share it out. That way more people can see it, and there'll be more likely a part two.
Yay!
Now I might do more of this one anyway. Seems pretty interesting, but I'll try to gauge your guys' interest in it more than anything, because I've got like several games going on at this point. In any case, check out these videos off to the side here, and see you later, guys, gals, my new YouTube pals. Ivan Kirkeehee, great. But of course, I'm always Kirkeehee. See you guys next video.